I'm standing here at the Women's Rights Pioneers Monument in Central Park, New York, New York. This stretch of statues features a number of prominent writers and thinkers, but this statue is the first to depict real historical women in Central Park. The addition of this statue of Sojourner Truth, Susan B. Anthony, and Elizabeth Cady Stanton is only the fifth statue in all of five boroughs to depict real historical women. Growing up in New York, I've noticed there is a lack of women participating in New York's street and park vendors economy. Just as women cannot readily be seen upon the bronze pedestal, so too are the majority of people behind the booth men. So, I've come out to ask the question, does life really imitate art?
Although there are no official statistics on the demographics of unlicensed vendors in the city, according to the Street Vendor Project, women make up less than a quarter of New York's vendors with official permits. This imbalance is absolutely noticeable when walking through any market, street fair, or park.
So I've decided to go undercover as three different lady vendors in Central Park and Washington Square Park to find out what it's like to be one of these women vendors. I wonder, how will my experiences change depending on my appearance? And will people's impressions of me be affected by a first glance? I got some friends to accompany me in going undercover, acting as reporters doing a story on New York Park vendors to get customers' raw reactions after coming to my table.
Here are my results.
Being good, I'm a bad bitch. I'm sick of motherfuckers trying to tell me how to live. Fuck that. Hoes hate under my pictures on the gram.
Hi, I'm selling haikus for $1. Would you like one?
Zooby zooby zoo. Zooby zooby zoo. Zooby zooby zoo. Zooby zoo zooby zoo. Mon Dieu qu'ils sont doux.
For this first persona, I wanted to appear as androgynous as possible. I softened my feminine features by wearing boxy overalls, a button-down shirt, and a short wig. I wanted this persona to come across artistic and passionate, so I added a zany shirt pattern, a Van Gogh mask, and some MoMA shoes. This persona was by far the easiest to inhabit, as it felt pretty comfortable presenting myself in this way.
Hello.
Hello. Hi, Maya Haiku.
Yes, absolutely.
Will you do a copy of my project for me?
Yeah.
Awesome.
You get to pick a color and pick a topic. You can also use them though.
This persona was the most successful. I had a line forming before I even sat down. More people stopped at my booth this first day than the other 2 days combined. Seemingly the most approachable of my personas, she attracted all different types of customers. But what was really special about this persona was her ability to get people to feel comfortable with her and leave people feeling a strong sense of positivity and truly enjoying their time at the booth. These two were having an especially great time, even sitting down to talk to me at eye level while waiting for their haiku. My undercover crew caught up with them afterwards to see what they thought of their experience.
What about vendors themselves specifically make you want to like stop at them?
Oh, I know it's one of my people like having their own business.
Always. Oh,
so I'm any of them, yeah.
Yeah, and if they look like they're honest and they're like enjoying it.
She was equally successful in Central Park as well.
So we were wondering, like, what attracted you to this that particular vendor? What drew you into the business?
So I believe in supporting a lot of local artists just because this is where we get our first start. I feel that it's very important for us to have a community that just supports each other. And also, I feel as though things happen for a reason. And I like to believe that, you know, people you meet during the day, they're meant to be there because they want to share something with you. So just let them. And doing little things like this, I feel like it's just letting destiny in a way just kind of talk to you. And the poem was beautiful.
Yeah. What set the impression of this persona apart was that even though university student was written on my sign each day, this was the only persona where every single interviewee continuously commented stopping at my booth because I was a student and looked like a real business. For some reason, this look legitimized the product itself.
I think it was the creativity on the spot and the fact that she's a student, and you knew it was going to be brilliant, and we're in New York, and what a gift. I was like, oh, I'd love to gift that to myself and to my friend.
Okay. And would you say there was like anything specific about the vendor themselves that attracted it to you, or more the product?
I liked what she was wearing.
Mm-hmm. Okay, cool.
She has a really warm. Young. Mm-hmm. She's really warm. She has beautiful eye contact.
Yeah.
And sincerity.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I mean, it totally picked up on her sincerity.
Mm-hmm. Okay, great.
Yeah, and she's not a salesman.
Mm-hmm. Not a salesman? This persona would beg to differ, earning a wage of $15.29 an hour, just over New York's minimum wage.
I am so fab. Check out, I'm rich. And I'm a little bit of a bitch. I wanna dress you up in silk. Tabitha. Tailor these clothes to fit your guilt. What's your size? This purse can hold my black card and tiara. Versace promises I will.
For my second persona, I tried to mimic appearances I see on social media and invoke the essence of an influencer type girl. To do this, I accentuated my feminine features, drawing attention to my figure and style, while spending extra time getting ready, doing my hair, and putting on makeup and jewelry. As I often see on Instagram, I also wanted to look like a girl attempting to look wealthy, wearing noticeably branded items. I was not comfortable in this outfit and felt very out of place in the parks. I felt invisible, and few people were drawn to the booth to stop and interact with me. However, those who did stop seemed weirdly determined to help and advise me. Like this guy, my only customer of the day in Central Park, walked by, staring at me, contemplating if he wanted to stop. He continued for a couple of minutes, absolutely torn whether or not to come to my booth. Something put him over the edge, and he ended up walking all the way back to get a poem. The entire time he waited for the poem, he was complaining about the musician next to me.
I know. That's actually my usual spot right in front of the Women's Monument.
Yeah, that makes sense.
But they took it from
me. Okay, yeah, denied. Next time, go take that back.
Uh-huh.
Adverse possession.
He did end up giving me the highest tip I got in the experiment of $5. But when my undercover crew tried to catch up with him, he refused the interview. This persona had a similar experience in Washington Square Park. After asking for my Instagram, this customer also gave me some tips for my booth.
You should use use a thicker tip.
Okay.
So like it's like extra fashionable.
After he got his haiku, he came back again and brought a friend with him. He then started propping up my sign and trying to corral customers over.
So, what about her specifically?
Well, she just sat down, right? And I know personally, I was just like, to give her a little bit of a little push, and be like, okay, this wasn't amazing.
Yeah.
He also ended up taking this picture of me. This persona may have wanted to appear more successful, but ended up making just $6.50 an hour.
Unsure what the balance held, I touched my belly overwhelmed by what I had been chosen to perform. But then an angel came one day, told me to kneel down and pray, for unto me a man child would be born. Oh, this crazy circumstance, I knew his life deserved a chance, but everybody told me to be smart. Look at your career, they said, Lauren, baby, use your head, but instead I chose to use my heart. Now the joy of my world is in Zion.
Now the joy of my world. For my last persona, I wanted to see how being pregnant would affect people's impressions of me as an artist and a student. So I tried to have a kept-up appearance of a pregnant woman confident in her behavior and choices. I probably felt more uncomfortable than I ever have in my entire life sitting with a fake pregnant belly on in public. People seemed confused and concerned more than anything, and no one wanted to stop. I wonder if COVID had something to do with people's adverse reactions. The entire time, I couldn't stop thinking about how weird it felt to have people staring at me as they were, and made me feel like this wasn't the audience for a pregnant person. This customer actually recognized me from the first day of filming, and his face trying to piece together how I got pregnant in a week was priceless, but terrified me. He did not stop at the booth today. I did have a bit of guilt from pretending to be pregnant in front of the Women's Monument, feeling like doing this was almost too taboo. Until, to my surprise, many of the parkgoers looking at the monument completely ignored me. For the few who did stop, there was no common reasoning customers shared for wanting to stop at my booth. However, no one mentioned my belly or the fact that my sign said student. The unusual dichotomy of appearing pregnant while also being in university seemed to cause people to put their own assumptions onto me.
What about that specific booth versus, you know, all the other ones in the park made you stop?
Maybe because she was a woman and a girl and, like, we were close in age, or relatively close, and I just wanted to see what she would write.
So why did you stop at the booth?
I'm always intrigued by haikus and I'm people who improvise, and I was kind of looking for a sign of some sort, so I was like, oh, this might be like something that inspired me. But I also was like, it's a dollar, I might as well just like
It felt to me that being pregnant discredited any legitimacy I had as a vendor, artist, or businesswoman. This was by far the least successful persona out of the three, earning just $5 an hour. The more feminine I became, the less successful I was. Through this experience, I've learned that New Yorkers like to have a clear understanding of where their money is going and what they'll get in return, which is validated for them by how good at poem writing I appear to be. I can confirm that my appearance definitely changed people's perspectives and expectations for me. It seemed that even in informal street business, a woman's income is determined by her ability to dress for success. I understand that many of the vendors in New York City do this job out of necessity. I have had the opportunity and privilege to do this project undercover, having the time, finances, and support available to make this project a reality. So, after my experiment, I went back to the park to donate all the money I made to someone who truly deserves it.
So the reason I'm interviewing Felicity today is because after doing my project and going undercover as, you know, different women vendors, I really wanted to come out here and be able to talk to someone who's actually doing that and actually experiencing that and trying to, you know, really put good stuff into the world by doing that. So I wanted to give you this, which is what I made during my time doing this, so that, you know, you can be rewarded and have what you deserve as someone coming out here every day and just trying to spread positivity and good art. So
thank
I really
you
appreciate
so
you.
Thank you so much. Thank you. That would be very helpful when I'm backpacking, because you don't really make a lot of money backpacking. So that'll be very helpful. Thank you.
Yes, thank you so much. I really appreciate what you're doing, and I hope you have a really, really successful thing, successful part with this, because your art is really amazing.
Did you like us to have a piece?
Oh, can I?
Yes, there's more pieces like in between those.
Oh my gosh, which one should I take?
Whichever one resonates with you.
Oh, I'm like really eyeing that one, but that one's a really nice piece.
Yeah, you can have it.
I can have it?
Like I said,
oh my gosh.
Somebody who could appreciate it.
Oh my god, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Awesome. Well, I'm Caroline Coyer, reporting from Washington Square Park, and I hope everyone has a blessed day.
Thank you.
Thank you.